justifying the massive optimism created among the legions of Rangers fans crammed into Easter Road this afternoon. A marvellous setting, one of the great days in the sporting year, the start of a new season. The pitch is immaculate, the sun is beating down overhead, and Easter Road is packed to capacity with crowds still waiting to come in from outside. So two very different teams from the Hibs and Rangers sides, which finished last season, and Souness is involved straight away in that midfield role for Rangers. Butcher under pressure immediately from Jordan McCluskey, and that's Munro going forward. And it's all a hectic start here as each side tries to assert themselves, particularly in midfield. Tremendous atmosphere inside Easter Road. Souness switching play to the right, and there's Bobby Russell. Rangers opening up with a three-man midfield with Russell, Durant and Souness. Mark Fulton at full stretch, got a touch. And back it goes to one of the most experienced players in the field, Alan Ruff, the Hibernian goalkeeper. Weir and Durant flashing, it was Kirkwood who stepped in. Billy Kirkwood is the new Hibs captain. Durant picking up the loose ball again, a bad pass back, there's McCluskey! And a brilliant save from Woods. Well, a moment of carelessness in that Rangers defence. Durant's pass back, totally lacking in conviction. Woods was exposed, but a worthy cover to block the shot from McCluskey. Of course, there's a corner kick to Hibs, taken by Weir. Done away by Ted McMinn. The smallest player of the Hibs team, Mickey Weir, will take the corner. As soon as his header, Corpolano sweeping it back out towards Weir, who's back to remain onside. Intelligent move from Weir. Good play from the middle midfield player, and it was Butchers who cleared that with a glancing header. And Rangers now on the counter-attack with Russell on the right. What a splendid start to the match. And a lot of the credit for that must go to Hibs. Russell is seeing a great deal of the ball for Rangers. That's a fine pass. McMinn in space now to attack the Hibs defence. Still McMinn. And it's rough at his best once again. Well, this match shaping up to be tremendous. McMinn doing well, showing his confidence, the ball going inside. A powerful shot and Ruff very quickly down to his right. Spinning off the head of Dawson, Butcher attacking the ball. Under pressure immediately though, and a fine tackle by Butcher using those telescopic legs. Danny Butcher, the most expensive player in Scottish football, £725,000 from Ipswich. His last competitive match was against Argentina for England in the World Cup. Souness picking out McMinn, just a shade too high that pass. Souness not at all happy with the movement up front, making some telling remarks to his front men. Good pass from Durant to Souness. Now Durant again. Good effort from long range. Confident enough to test the international goalkeeper Alan Ruff. But the shot was wide. Munro jousting again with Mickey Weir. That's one for Cowan to chase with Butcher. Cowan sending it across, the chance is now on for Beedie. 1-0 to Hibs. Stuart Beedie's first for his new club, and the Hibs supporters have gone wild. Well, what a shaker for Rangers. 15 minutes on the clock. It was the long ball played forward with Steve Cowan giving chase with Butcher. Cowan won that little bit of wrestling with Butcher, but an intelligent ball across the face of the goal, and there was Stuart Beedie to force the ball home in the far corner. One rose header. Chisholm lofting it high. Good to Cowan. Neat touch on. There's Weir. Some great play now from Hibs. Cowan goes on the outside. Weir uses him as a decoy, and he still has support on the left. Well, that was perhaps a shade optimistic from Mickey Weir after some excellent play coming forward. Lots of time now for Munro, for Rangers. Butcher picks out Dawson. Good control from West. Now Russell. And the hustling tactics of Hibs paying off in midfield. Rangers finding it very hard to play telling passes forward. So back across the back four. McPherson now to Russell. That's one for West to nod down towards McCoist. Down goes McCoist, and the penalty kick is awarded. The Hibs players are incensed. The referee, Mike Delaney, is adamant, and Alan Ruff will get himself into trouble, I think, if he continues. But an opportunity now for Rangers to get back in level terms, and Hibs defenders clearly think that McCoist died. Well, the ball hoisted in by Bobby Russell. West doing what he's been bought to do, nodding it down. McCoist bursting clear, goes down in a bundle there as he clashes with Chisholm, and then the referee gives the penalty kick, which has incensed the Hibs supporters. It also incensed Alan Ruff, and that's why he's become the first player in the match to be booked. So Ruff now facing Ali McCoist, who will take the penalty kick for Rangers. And Billy Kirkwood, the Hibs captain, being spoken to also by referee Delaney. In fact, he also is being booked. Well, there's no question that McCoist went down in dramatic fashion. Very difficult from this angle to see whether he was struck or not by Chisholm. But the penalty kick's been given, and here's Ali McCoist. Superbly done. Equaliser for Rangers, and joy for the Rangers fans. Well, perhaps not coming in the most satisfactory fashion, but Ali McCoy starting off the new season the way he finished the last. Sending Alan Ruff the wrong way, a powerfully struck penalty kick into the opposite corner, and Ruff had no chance at all.
It's won by Sneddon. Brought down by Durant. Free kick this time to Hibs. Weir leaves it to Chisholm. Headed away by Dawson on this far.
He's incensed. The referee will take action against the Rangers player manager. Well, I'd like to think that Kirkwood's pace going onto the ball was the factor which brought about the bad late tackle. Sunnis certainly offering his apology to referee Mike Delaney, but the yellow card is shown. Kirkwood going onto the ball from the headed clearance from Dawson, sidestepping Sunnis, and in came that crunching late tackle. Three-man Rangers wall as the free kick is organised by Stuart Beedie. It was intended for Chisholm, just a shade too high. Bigman using his strength, and that's for McCoist to chase. A great chance for Rangers. West also in support. Well, a tremendous break from Rangers. A chance in the end between McCoist and West. McCoist racing forward, using West, who had more space on his left. And the final shot, lacking confidence and conviction.
Kirkwood, the space for May. McPherson's there for Rangers. Very inventive play coming from Hibs as they go forward. Getting the midfield men up in support of the front men, Cowan and McCluskey. And ball thumped into the Rangers crowd behind Chris Wood's goal for the corner kick by McPherson. Weir's corner kick. Up goes Souness. Kirkwood!
Tremendous effort from Billy Kirkwood. We've seen that so often from him in Dundee United colours. And a good save again from Woods at the expense of a corner kick.
Weir again with a corner.
Woods is in trouble. He seemed to be bumped in the air by McCluskey, and that's how the referee saw it.
So tempers rising again in the penalty box.
Would certainly appear to be bumped as the ball was in the air as he came off his line, and the referee was ideally situated to spot that.
McCluskey winning the corner kick off Stuart Munro. So Hibs undoubtedly having the edge in corner kicks. It's their fifth against only two from Rangers. The more important statistic is one goal apiece. Here's corner, Woods underneath it. Surviving the challenge of George McCluskey, which I think would have been penalised by referee Delaney had Woods not held onto the ball.
Good play from Souness. Immediately under pressure though from Beedie. Well, that's an aspect of the Scottish game with which Graham Souness may not be familiar. And tempers have gone completely now. McCluskey and Beedie, as soon as he's in the heart of it, Chris Woods wants to take his own kind of action. And this is a dreadful scene inside Easter Road. And off the ball, more trouble as Mark Fulton goes down. A collision with Colin West. And now the Hibs players turn their attention on the former Watford striker. Now Graham Souness may be in severe trouble here. He's already been booked, remember. Well, the game has been simmering right from the start. A flashpoint was perhaps inevitable. We've seen it now, and what action will be taken by referee Delaney? The Hibs supporters going wild on the far side, but the red card has been shown to Graham Souness. Graham Souness has been ordered off, and Easter Road is going wild. George McCluskey showing Souness the damage inflicted. So Souness' first competitive game for Rangers lasts 37 minutes. So McCluskey is off injured, Souness is ordered off. And referee Mike Delaney will be praying now that the match can settle down. Walter Smith is on the track for Rangers reorganising the ranks in the absence of Souness. And on comes Willie Irvine, the former Stirling Albion striker. He's gone on to replace McCluskey. And Mike Delaney now conferring with both linesmen because there was a lot of activity which he did not see. But now he's been advised of Colin West's attack on Mark Fulton. And that will mean, undoubtedly, Rangers reduced to 9 men. No, indeed, a yellow card suffices. Well, that's a major surprise because it certainly appeared as though there was a collision off the ball with Fulton very much the victim, and West certainly appeared to be the aggressor on that occasion. West having a word with the linesman, and that's certainly an act of folly also because that could certainly make the red card inevitable. There's Walter Smith on the track, trying to sort out Rangers, reduced to 10 men. It's one apiece, and there's McMinn tackling Weir, and Durant goes crunching in. Weir thinking about wreaking vengeance. Well, whatever will we see next?
Does it
Cowan's first touch. Now Weir. He's away from McPherson. Good help inside. Back it goes to Cowan. And he couldn't get power into the shot. Under intense pressure, of course, from the Rangers' defence. But yet another good attacking move from Hibs. And Mickey Weir, once again, the little number eight, was involved. Durant goes in for the high ball, it breaks for Kirkwood. McCoist having to go back to help in defence, this is Irvin. There's a chance, and it's Steve Cowan for Hibs! Two-one to Hibs! And the celebrations begin among the men wearing the green and white favours. And once again, another inventive move from Hibs. Willie Irvin doing well, breaking on the left, getting into a shooting position, angling the ball across Chris Woods, who couldn't reach it. Steve Cowan could, and Hibs are in front once again. Long ball forward signals the end of a torrid first half. And if you like football, the red meat variety, you've had it in plenty here at Easter Road. And the flashpoint coming in the 37th minute when Graham Souness was involved the second time and asked the incident and was ordered off in the most dramatic fashion, with a number of other players very fortunate to remain on the field in that unseemly melee which developed. But at the end, the most important statistic is the half-time scoreline, which is Hibs 2, Rangers 1. Off that from West. Here's Russell. McCoist breaking in the right. Good play from McCoist. The chance for Rangers. And it's missed by West in the end. Well, a great opportunity goes a begging again for the big Rangers striker. Good build up with McCoist being released on the right, showing good control as he brought the ball inside, slanting it across. West came in and Ruff was certainly out of position, but the shot goes wide. By Dawson, Irvin coming in his blind side. Bocolano. Easy one again for Chris Woods. Irvin taking up good position on the left to take the throw out. What a good turn of speed he has. Got down by Chisholm. And referee Delaney's going to take some action against the Hibs defender. Well, it may not appear to bring down Billy Kirkwood to continue his run up the left flank, and Chisholm appeared committed, but the referee taking a very firm grip on the proceedings right at the start of the second half. And Graham Souness has now appeared in the director's box after his early bath, in fact hiding there on the staircase, trying not to be too obvious. And a fine pass to McMinn. A lot of space to work. McPherson has gone forward to join the attack. And it's cut off by Gordon Chisholm. Doing a little bit too much in the ball though, the Hibs defender. Corner kick's been given to Rangers. McMinn is the man in a hurry. Everyone going into the box for Rangers, all the big men up. One of them's Butcher. And Roth going down to his right, it's helped away by Mickey Weir. But Rangers are not out of it yet. Short corner this time to Derek Ferguson. It was missed by everyone and it's gone behind for a goal kick to Hibs, much to the relief of Alan Roth. Well, Butcher came very close indeed to his first goal for Rangers. Oh, Hibs prepared to retain possession of the ball as long as it takes.
Walter Smith on the bench for Rangers going crazy at the fact that his men are not pushing up to apply pressure. Cowan challenged by Butcher. But a jersey holding there by Cowan, and Butcher reacts very angrily now. That was another bad incident, perhaps the first of the second half. And what action will be taken by referee Delaney? It certainly was a foul for Rangers. No question that Cowan pulled the jersey of Terry Butcher, but it was a lashing out with the right elbow which may well cause the real problem. So the paperwork begins again. It's Steve Cowan who is being booked, and I don't think he's any complaint at all. There's a clear case of jersey holding. But what will he do about Terry Butcher afterwards? Well, the message is perfectly clear from the referee. The yellow card for Cowan. And I think the referee's not yet finished. No, indeed, he's having a word with the Rangers captain. And indeed, he's reacting to the retaliation shown by Butcher. Merely frustration for the England centre-half. No, the tally is 7 bookings and 1 ordering off. So Hibs supporters will celebrate in style, I'm sure, when the final whistle goes, if the scoreline remains the same. So Chris Woods organising his wall in anticipation of the free kick. So Ray is fit to resume. May to Kirkwood, Kirkwood heading for the corner flag. Well, it's a great pity the game has to end in such a fashion with this blatant time wasting. The argument is that it's professional, but it certainly isn't something the fans come to see. But Chris Woods trying to get Rangers back in attack. The header by Snedden. One for Irvin to chase, but Woods is there first. No option this time, has to launch the long one forward. And Tortolano sensibly sending it back to Alan Ruff. The referee is checking his watch. The Hibs supporters getting ready for what will be, I'm sure, a tumultuous roar at the end. The Rangers fans disappearing from behind Alan Ruff's goal, sensing that defeat is now inevitable. And there goes the final whistle. Celebrations begun by Alan Ruff and continued by everyone wearing green and white around Easter Road. But they are the dejected supporters this afternoon. The Rangers fans depleted to some extent behind the goal. The applause coming from the Hibs fans. There are handshakes happily on the field at the moment, but a game which will sadly always be remembered for that dreadful incident. 8 minutes from half-time, which resulted in the Rangers player-manager Graham Souness being ordered off in his first competitive match for his new club.
Yes, what a game and what a start.
It was going to be like that, and especially with Rangers signing all the big names. The crowd was expectant, you know, of a good game, and we were all revved up for a good game as well. I think this thing's boiled over a centre.
Your experience would tell you, of course, that playing against 10 men doesn't always necessarily give you the advantage, and I think today was perhaps no exception to that, Will.
Like, personally, I hate playing against 10 men because 9 times out of 10 they always snatch an equaliser or a winner, because they always keep it solid at the back and hit you on the break and try and suck you in. Mm-hmm. So we just have to keep our discipline and play from there and hope to get another one and finish them off.
Last question, you must be looking forward to the games to come.
Yes, well, Wednesday's the next important game, and after today we've got to forget about today and take 2 points on Wednesday and take it from there.